A very good evening to all of you and welcome back. Today we are going to talk about how to backup and restore data in Tele ERP 9. Previously I had published a video on how to configure default company in Tele, and you can go and watch that video. I have given the link in video description and in the cards. And in that video I had explained a few things about the number in front of the company name and the path where Tele stores its data. And I had also talked about the teleconfiguration IN file. So let's get started with this video. And if you move to the folder where you have installed Tele, so basically I have Tele ERP 964 bit installed. So on C drive, I will go to program files folder and here I can find Tele ERP 9. However, there is a newer version of Tele, Tele Prime, and you can also download that for free, the educational versions. So here we have that folder, and inside that folder, if you see here, you can look for that file, configuration setting file, and if you right click on that file and choose property, then you can see that it has an extension of .ini. So if I open that file, then you can see the data folder path here. So the default company is set to yes, and the folder path is C users public Tele ERP 9 data folder. So why I am showing you this, because if you run Tele and if the default company is set to no, and if there is no company exist in Tele ERP 9 database, and then you see this screen of company information. Otherwise, if the default company is set to yes and there is a company, then it will automatically select that company and then you will see gateway of Tele instead of company info menu. So if I press enter here, select company, then on top in front of path you can see the exact same path that is written in Tele INA configuration setting file. You can also change that path, but we will talk about that later on. But if I select the default path, then you can see that there is no company exist in that folder. So if I move to my computer and then go to C users public and here Tele ERP 9 data folder, you can see that this folder is empty. So if I create a new company, let's say, so here we have one company and I am going to shut that company by pressing Alt F1, or you can also press this button. So now if I move back to the same folder, then you can see we have a folder here with a name 10,000. So here you can see all the corresponding file, the database file for your company. So as I told you that there are two methods of backing up and restoring data in Tele ERP 9. So the first method that mostly people use is that they just copy this data folder, right click on this folder and choose copy, and then they paste on that on a pen drive or on another drive. So let's say I paste that folder on D drive. So I can also select the same company by pressing on select company, and here now I change the path by typing D:// data. So now if I press enter, then you can see that we have the same exact company that we just created previously and stored that into user public Tele ERP 9 data folder. So you can also backup your companies by just copying the data folder. So if I move to the E drive and here under Rajiv data, you can see this folder Tele ERP data, and here you can see we have four subfolders and these four folders corresponding to four different companies. So if I want to access this data under Tele ERP 9, so what I can do, I can go to select company and here I can type the full path Tele:// Rajiv data/Tele ERP data. So the path is not case sensitive and you can type in smaller or capital letters. Then you can see all the companies available in these subfolders according to their numbers. You can see the same numbers as the folder names. So one way is backing up the data is to just copy the entire data folder and place it on the pen drive or on any another drive. But the correct method of backing up data is these two commands, backing up and restoring. So if I press enter on this backup data option, then on top you are seeing that the source, you have to tell the source where the companies are stored and from where you want to take the backup. So you can also change that part. Like I can type here, I want to backup these company which are saved under archive data, tell the ERP data, enter, and I want the destination folder to be E drive root. And now it is showing all the four companies that are available in those source folder. So it is asking you that which company you want to backup. So let's say I want to backup all those four, so I can press enter on all items. Or I can also choose to backup only a single or two companies, like I want to backup this KCI and this demo company. End of list. And it will create a backup file on root of the E drive. So I press enter. Now if we move to the E drive, on the root of E drive, then you can see this file here. So you can't open or use this file directly from the root of the E drive. You can only access this file using the restore command in Tele ERP. So let me show you another example of by backing up this test company, and later we will delete this company and will restore that company from the backup. So what I do, I press enter on backup, and here I choose /users/public/tele.erp9/data, where is the test company is stored, and where I want to backup that data. I want to backup that on /e, let's say data, and I want to type in date 6/04/2021, and that is the company which is available under user public. I want to backup that, and let's say now backup is done. And what I now do, I select the company test, and here you can see this button here, company info. You can also press Alt F3 and that will bring the company information menu. And here if you move to alter and press enter on your company name, and if you want to delete this company, you can either delete the folder, corresponding folder from the destination where the data is stored, like C user public tele ERP. You can also go in that folder and can delete this subfolder here, this one 10,000, and it will also delete the company. Or you can come here in the company information and go to alter, and here you press Alt D to delete the company. And if I press yes, then it will remove that company. Are you sure? Yes. Now if I press select company, then you can see that that company is gone now. So if I by mistake I have deleted the company and I have the backup, then I can restore that company from those backups. So what I can do, I can go to the restore, and here it is also asking the same thing, destination and source. So the destination I want to make that same, and here under source you can see the same folder where we have taken the backup of test company /data 26/04/2021. And if I press enter, then you will see the companies available in the source. So here we have that test company, and end of list. And I want to restore that now. Yes. Now if I go to the select company, then you can see the same companies available back from the restore. Now if I press enter on the select company, then you can see we have the same company available back again from the backup that we have just taken previously. So I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting. And you can also subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a great day.